Good morning. This is so good. A nice way to start your morning. A nice smoothie. Very delicious. So today is Monday, and I am just, it's almost the end of the month. So I am just kind of packing up, getting back, because I took a break. Actually, to be honest, I took two weeks break, and I did not pack anything. And I kind of hate that because it's almost time for me to move. And I think that I just got overwhelmed. I did. I got overwhelmed because now my house is like, it looks cluttered. And that's because I have boxes and stuff everywhere, and it's not neat and organized like it was. And so I'm looking all over the place, and I'm trying to like try to figure out, okay, which way do I go? Do I go in the kitchen and start the kitchen again? Do I start my classroom? Do I start the living room? Do I start upstairs? You know, and I did. I got overwhelmed, and my daughter is not here, so basically I had to go in her room and clean out her room, and which it was already clean, but I had to separate all, because a lot of her clothes, it's like two big bags of clothes that she don't want. And I'm talking about those construction bags, two bags of those that she don't want. So I'm trying to bag that up so that I can give all of this stuff to Salvation Army. I have a lot of stuff that I want to give away to Salvation Army. So I'm just trying to really bag up everything, you know, put it to the side so that either they come and get it. I don't know if they, you know, come to the house and get it, because they used to, but I don't know what the circumstances now. Or I have to drop it off myself. So I'm just trying to get all this stuff out of the way. And I'm a little overwhelmed. It's like every room I look into, it's like I still got stuff laying around. And I did, I think maybe 3 weeks. I didn't do anything. I did no packing in April. And this is almost the end of the month. I did no packing in April. And I think the end of March, I don't think I did anything. I mean, I got overwhelmed because when I started, I just started going and packing and packing and packing in each room instead of doing one room at a time. And I think that was my mistake, is that I started going all over the place, you know, and I should have just went room to room, room to room. And I didn't do that, you know. I couldn't focus on one thing at a time. So that was my mistake with having ADHD. You know, you're all over the place. So that's what I did. So it looks a little chaotic. I mean, every room looks chaotic. So I got overwhelmed, and I was like, you know what? I'm not doing anything. And it was like I wanted to. But every time I would look, like I said, I would get overwhelmed and like, I don't know where to start, you know. And then that got me down, you know, I got depressed and stuff like that because, like I said, the house is not organized. It's not, you know, it's cluttered. And even though this is a big house, it's a really big house. The fact is that when things is not organized, you get kind of down, you know, when you're used to having everything organized and neat and clean and stuff like that. When it's chaotic and stuff is everywhere, it affects your mental state. And that's what it did to me. It affected my mental state. So I kind of just gave up. And that's like in your life. If you got a lot of stuff going on in your life, you got a lot of negative energy around you and stuff like that. You got a lot of things going on. It really can affect your mental state. So you have to organize your state of mind. And for real, I'm serious when I say that. It's like you have to organize your state of mind, because if your life is not organized, it's going to get overwhelming and it's going to affect you, and you're not going to be able to be your best. You know what I'm saying? Because you're going to be all over the place. So organize yourself, organize your state of mind so that you can be able to give your best. You know, when you got a clean, organized house, you feel good. You know, you can make clear, good decisions, you know, but when your house is a mess, you're a mess. You get what I'm saying? If your house is a mess, you're a mess. So organize your house, organize you, what's going on with you, you know, the people that you're around, all of that, organize that, get all of that out of the way. You know what I'm saying? The things that you don't need, organize it, you know. I don't need this right here. You know, I'll keep this, you know, I'll put this to the side and I'll use this when I need it. You know, that's what I'm talking about as far as people. You know, this one is too toxic, I'm throwing that out. This one right here is okay, I can keep him at a distance. Okay, this one right here is a keeper. I need this in my life. I need this person in my life. They make me feel good. They're positive. They have good energy. I'm going to keep this. You put that in that file. The ones that's right there that you say is so-so, where, you know, I can work with them when I go to work. I'm good with them, but I don't want them coming home with me, okay? I can keep them at work and we good, but not coming home. This one, I don't even want at work. I don't want them in my life, so I'm throwing them away. So organize that. Organize that so you can be the best person that you want to be in your life. You know what I'm saying? So now, so good. Now I'm back at it. Now I'm back at it again. And I have to, because I'm getting ready to move. So I can't take no more time. I can't take 2 weeks, 3 weeks. You know, because in the next couple weeks, I'm out of here. So I have to make sure that within these 2 weeks, I gotta be packed, and it's gonna be overwhelming, and the journey, it's gonna be a journey. But you guys, you know, I'm gonna kind of like take y'all along with me so you can see what I've been doing. But yeah, my life is chaotic right now because I need to get my house in order. Okay, so that's what I'm doing. But for right now, it's morning. And it's 11 o'clock, and that's why I'm drinking my breakfast, because I eat from 11 to 7. I do that intermittent fasting. I don't know if I'm saying it. Intermittent fasting, where I eat 11 to 7. And then after 7, I don't eat anything else. And I've been slipping a little bit. Like I said, my life been a little disorganized and, you know, chaotic. And I haven't really been on track. But the thing of it is that I still eat 11 to 7. I might even go 12, 1, 2, 3 o'clock before I even eat anything. But I've been going past 7. And that's my thing. It's like I can start at 11. And I never start at 11. Today is the only time I'm starting at 11. But usually I start 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, sometimes 5 o'clock. But then I go over to 7 o'clock. So now I'm trying to get back to 11 to 7. And the only thing that you can have during that period is you can drink as much water as you want. You can drink tea if you want. And I usually drink like my kombucha juice. So you can drink that. But other than that, after 7, just water or tea if you want. You can't eat or drink anything else. Oh, I'm just going to take a sip of pop. Or I'm going to take a sip of juice. You can't. So that's what I've been doing. So I'm getting back to that, getting myself back organized so that I can get this packing done, have a clear mind, you know, so that I can not be depressed and get down and stuff like that, so I can finish my packing before it gets to the point where I'm trying to rush and do it, and then I'm throwing everything in boxes and stuff like that, and I don't want that. I want to be organized. So that's what I'm trying to do now, you guys. If you guys want to see how I made this, step by step, how I made this, stay tuned, okay? Stay tuned. After I drink this, then I'm going to show you how I made it, okay? Very healthy. So, again, you want to know how I made this? Stay tuned, okay? Have a good day. And take in what I said, okay? Take in everything that I said and apply it, okay? If you don't need it, throw it away. If you do, keep it, okay? Bye. Stay tuned.